हेलो, वेलकम ऑल. आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट कैन्यूला. कैन्यूला इज अ फ्लैक्सिबल ट्यूब दैट कैन बी इंसर्टेड इन टू द बॉडी एंड फॉर मेडिकल यूज. देयर आर 11 डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कैन्यूला एंड द मोस्ट कॉमनली यूज आर द इंट्रावेनस एंड द नेजल कैन्यूला. And cannula is a thin tube inserted into a vein or body cavity to administer medications, drain off fluid, or insert a surgical instrument. And length of cannula. Cannula are different size, length, like product code, gauze, color, catheter, packaging and measurements. Now, indications of cannulations. Repeated blood sampling, intravenous fluid administration, intravenous medications administration and intravenous chemotherapy administration. And next one is intravenous nutritional support and intravenous blood or blood product administration. Now last one is intravenous administration of radiological contrast agents for computed tomography, magnetic resonance imaging or nuclear imaging. Now procedure of cannulation. First of all, introduce yourself to patient and equipment for intravenous cannulations and sanitize your hands using alcohol cleansers and apply the tourniquet and recheck the vein and clean the patient's skin with the alcohol wipe and then remove the needle cover and approach with a confident, calm, caring attitude. Now collect your equipments. All are the equipments. All equipments are necessary to collect. Then wash hand properly. Now selecting a vein. Veins of the forearm. First one is cephalic vein. Next, second one is medial cubital vein. Third one is accessory cephalic vein. Fourth one is basilic vein. Fifth one is cephalic vein. Last one is medial antibrachial vein. Now veins of the hand. First one is digital dorsal veins. Second one is dorsal metacarpal veins. Third one is dorsal venous network. And the last one is basilic vein and cephalic vein. Now what is the site should be avoided in cannulations like wrist, legs, feet, ankles, veins below a previous IV infiltration, vein below a phlebotic area and scleroid or thrombosed veins, areas of skin inflammations and arm affected by a radial mastectomy, an edema, blood clot or infection. Arm with an arteriovenous shunt of fistula. Now, how to apply the tourniquet? First of all, apply tourniquet and clean area with alcohols. Now remove the नीडल के नीडल कवर एंड इंसर्ट नीडल बेवल अपवर्ड एट अबव 30 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड एंड एडवांस द रेस्ट ऑफ कैन्यूला इनटू द वेन. नाउ रिलीज द टैनिकेट एंड अप्लाई प्रेशर एट द टिप ऑफ कैन्यूला एंड रिमूव द नीडल. सी द प्रोसीजर इन द पिक्चर. नाउ अप्लाई द प्लास्टर. नाउ अप्लाई दिस इज अप्लाई द प्लास्टर टू फिक्स इट ऑन द प्लेस. Then complications of cannulations in local complication and in systematic complications. In local complications, infiltration, extravasations and thrombosis, cellulitis and phlebitis. In systemic complications, embolism like pulmonary embolism, air embolism and catheter embolism and hematoma, systemic infections and speed shock, circulatory overload, allergic reaction. What is the local complication? This picture is the local complications like infiltration. Now what is the infiltration? Infiltration is the infusion of fluid and medications outside the intravascular space into the surrounding soft tissues. Air embolism, extravascular injection, etc. And how it treats or how it treated. First of all, elevated the site as much as possible to help reduce the swelling and apply a warm or cold compress depending on the fluid for 30 minutes every 2 to 3 hours to help reduce the swelling and discomfort. Now, medications, if recommended, medicines for extravasations is given within the 24 hours for best effect. And next one is extravasation. What is extravasation? Extravasation is a leaking of vesicant drugs into surrounding tissues and it can cause severe local tissue damage and possibly leading to delayed healing, infection, tissue necrosis and loss of function and even amputations. Now, what action would you consider for a patient with extravasation? If extravasation occurs, the injection should be stopped immediately and the IV tubing disconnected and avoid applying pressure to the site and don't flush the line and leave the original catheter in place and attempt to aspirate as much of infiltrated drug as possible. Now, thrombosis. Thrombosis occurs when blood flow through a vein is obstructed by a local thrombus. And now next one is cellulitis. Now what is the cellulitis? Cellulitis complications is very serious. These can include extensive tissue damage and tissue death. And the infection can also spread to blood, bones, lymph system, heart and nervous system. And what is the main causes of cellulitis? Cellulitis occurs when bacteria, most commonly Streptococcus and Streptophylococcus, enters through a crack or break in your skin. द इंसिडेंस ऑफ अ मोर सीरियस स्टेफाइलोकोकस इन्फेक्शन कॉल्ड मेथिसिलिन रेजिस्टेंट स्टेफाइलोकोकस ओरियस इज इंक्रीजिंग एंड हाउ टू अवॉइड सेल्युलाइटिस. डोंट यूज हाइड्रोजन परऑक्साइड और एल्कोहल विच कैन स्लो हीलिंग. इफ यू हैव स्वेलिंग इन योर लेग्स एडिमा सपोर्ट स्टॉकिंग एंड गुड स्किन केयर मे हेल्प प्रिवेंट लेग सोर्स एंड सेल्युलाइटिस एंड टेक केयर ऑफ योर फीट स्पेशली इफ यू हैव डायबिटीज और अदर कंडीशंस दैट इंक्रीजेज द रिस्क ऑफ इन्फेक्शन. नाउ नेक्स्ट वन इज फ्लेबाइटिस. नाउ वॉट इज फ्लेबाइटिस. फ्लेबाइटिस कॉम्प्लिकेशंस में इंक्लूड लोकल इन्फेक्शन एंड एब्सेसेस फॉर्मेशन क्लॉट फॉर्मेशन एंड प्रोग्रेशन टू अ डीप वेनस थ्रोम्बोसिस एंड पल्मोनरी एम्बोलिज्म. नाउ वेनस थ्रोम्बोफ्लेबाइटिस एंड सीरियसली डैमेज द लेग वेन्स. दिस कैन लीड्स टू पोस्ट फ्लेबाइटिस सिंड्रोम. And what is the biggest concern with phlebitis at an IV site? The biggest concern in short term is spread from the superficial vein to a deep vein. And long term, the phlebitis can reoccur. And rarely, infection can arise in the clotted veins, which is associated with high fever and redness that extends well past the affected veins. Now, what are IV fluids? IV fluids solution administered through an IV helps maintain the blood pressure, hydration, electrolyte balance. IV fluids is the intravenous fluid usually written as IV fluids are liquids given to replace water, sugar, salts that you might need if you are ill or having an operation and can't eat or drink as you would normally. And IV fluids are given straight into a vein through a drip. Now, there are three types of IV fluids: isotonic, hypotonic, and hypertonic. Then first one is isotonic solution. Isotonic solution are IV fluids that have a similar concentration of dissolved particles as blood. And what is hypotonic solution? Hypotonic solutions have a lower concentration of dissolved solutes than blood. Now last one is hypertonic solution. And why patient need IV fluids? Because IV are one of the most common things in health care and they are used to prevent dehydration, maintain blood pressure or give patients medicines or nutrients if they can not eat. And when should IV fluids be given? This can be caused by excessive external fluids and electrolyte loss as well as bleeding or plasma loss, usually from the gastrointestinal tract or severe internal losses. And routine maintenance, patient may need IV fluid therapy because they are unable to maintain normal fluid levels orally or by other internal routes. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you understand, but still you have any problem, you can comment. So we will continue rest of our topic in next video.